Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's performance of Scotland 4, Australia 1 will begin in just a few moments. Please consider your fellow patrons and ensure your mobile phone is either switched off or turned to silent. I'll probably keep mine on. No one ever phones me anyway. I don't think anyone gives a flying fuck about me. I'm just a sound engineer. This isn't even my real voice. This is my real voice! I don't get any praise or recognition! No mythomaniac groupies for me! I just do the sound! Check! One, two, check! Why are you people even here tonight? Tickets for Jimmy Carr sold out, were they? Well, I hope you like the show. I hope you die laughing. As for your mobile phones, keep them on. I really couldn't care. You always do anyway. Nobody has ever listened to a word I say. I've had enough. I don't care anymore. I've had it with a lot of you. You won't even know what a VU meter actually does. I'm going to do this for the sound engineers everywhere. Now, if I'm not mistaken, if I put this knife in this toaster... Stop! Stop! Stop!
Tony Blair, just sit right down and listen to the story of why we are here. Started out in Glasgow, we sold out 7 days. We got stuck right back to Edinburgh. Do you believe you choose your fate? Money's in the toilet, we've got nothing left to lose. So we sing this song together. If you love yourself, you'll sing it. Scotland 4, Australia 1. For the next 60 minutes, we'll be focused in on having fun. Australia won. If you didn't like us, then you probably wouldn't come. Scotland 4, Australia won. We just want to make you happy so you can tell your mom. Scotland 4, Australia won. Now the drum machine is finished and we have to wrap it up.
Show. Right, and it's going to be great, it's going to be fantastic, right, we've got tons to get through, we're going to start off with just a little bit of stand-up comedy, you up for that?
Yeah!
Fantastic, okay, here's something like this. And a little bit of clapping now. And a bit of cheering. Yeah! Now welcome on stage to the wonderful Mr. Kieran McAllister!
Yeah! Oh, last ever audience, nice to see you all, how are you all doing? Excellent, welcome to Scotland 4, Australia 1. So called because it takes four miserable Scottish bastards to counteract one genie chuppy irritating Australian. Because they're happy all the fucking time. We're in a flat together, there's five of us in this flat. The four Scottish boys get up at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. The Australian boys have been up since 7 o'clock in the morning, been for a run, made three new friends and organised a trip to Thailand. I haven't done that in my fucking life yet. Seriously, come back to the show next year, it's going to be called Australia One. Yeah, because I was going to do a show this year. You've heard the puppetry of the penis. Yeah, I was going to do a show this year called Puppetry of the Vagina. And then I'm performing cunts and then you went to the military tattoo because that's a some interesting things in the news recently, though. I've been reading they're going to start prescribing E's to terminally ill patients. That's a fucking great idea, isn't it? There's nets all over Glasgow now by a wood strap to each ear, lying under sunbeds for long lengths of time and hanging around cancer wards. Because I think it's contagious, you know. But can you imagine going up to see your Uncle Jack who's terminally ill in bed and he's not there? Going to the nurse, excuse me, where's my Uncle Jack? He's meant to be in bed hooked up to this machine. Nurse says, well, he was here a wee minute ago when we came round and gave him his medication. And then the Happy Mondays came on hospital radio. Now he's trying to start a conga line in the amputee box. They're all wrong. But the Michael Jackson trial as well, that was great from comedians out there. They were all going, yeah, that was fantastic. Because here's a guy, right, who went off innocent, right? There's a guy in Dundee where I live had his flat burnt down because he had the Crankies on DVD. Where's the justice? I bet Fred West is going, if only I could have fucking moonwalked. You know what I'm saying? It's all wrong. Because if Michael Jackson had lived in this country, we would have booted him out round about the time he was fucking okay. You know, allegedly Macaulay Culkin was one of his first victims. And you can't help thinking to yourself, I kind of saw that one coming. Do you know what I mean? If you only leave your 8-year-old every time you go on holiday, these people prey on those situations. We thought Michael Jackson's face was like that because of plastic surgery. It wasn't, it was because he was running into all those traps that McCullough left around the house. But I'm a youth worker in Dundee, that's what I do when I'm not doing this. Youth work, by the way, is the best contraception you've ever used in your entire fucking life. I'm not joking. I wear 7 condoms, have a wank these days in case I accidentally spawn one of the little devil fuckers. Seriously, have you heard of that ADHD, Attention Deficit Hyperactive Disorder? Right, a little cunt syndrome, as it's called. I took some of these guys in outdoor ed recently. Right, outdoor education is when you take inner city kids into the countryside because there's a wider variety of things for them to destroy. It's fantastic. We went mountain biking, right? I was standing in the middle of this forest in the pissing rain, right? And having this argument with a kid called Bob, right? Going, Bob, would you put down that frog? Bob, please put down that frog, you're hurting it. Bob, don't throw that frog at him. He's got it by the legs going, why is it not making the noise? Go ding 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 ding. No, but I was wondering, why were these guys right? And I said, right, if you're good for one week, if you don't piss around and kill us or anything, right, well, go and do something that you'll enjoy. So they decided they wanted to go swimming, because they're not that imaginative in Dundee, right? So we went local, they're all standing there in their burbity trunks, smoking cigarettes at the side of the pool. And I said, right, guys, well, you're in here, fucking behave, right? This is a public place, don't mess around. Turn my back for a moment, it was like the Ant Hill mob on speech, right? Just listen to these wee guys running around. And I was in the pool and one of them landed a particularly good dead arm on me. And I'm not advocating this as good childcare practice, but I started to swim after the little cunt, right? I grabbed him by the legs about halfway up the pool, I'm hauling him through the water like that, and punching him on the arms and legs, I turned him round to give him a wedgie, and it wasn't him! It was a midget doing legs. My guys were on the diving boat hunting a piss. It's a bad experience. But who's visiting Edinburgh? Give us a shout! Excellent, excellent. It's quite good. We quite like taking the piss out of tourists at this time of year. It's quite bad. I've been watching a wee American kid watching a guy with a kilt go down the Royal Mail and he's going, gee, what's underneath your kilt? What the fuck do you think is underneath his kilt? A small boy playing the bagpipes? Taken from behind by the Loch Ness Monster? I don't know. But if you're visiting Edinburgh, my favourite place, you've got to go if you've got time. Top of the Royal Mail on the left hand side, there's a little shop and it's actually called Thistle Do Nicely. That's what it's called. Right. Who in the name of flying fuck buys a suit of armour? I want to know. I want to see the cunt in it. I'm going to get a big magnet and run across busy roads. Right? But you go into this shop and the staff look like they've been knitted, right? They're these wee women. And you go up to the counter, this is no word of a lie, right? You go up to the counter, they've got a little thing, a little basket of Edinburgh tablet, a little basket of Edinburgh rock, and a little basket of haggis-flavoured condoms. I shit you not. Haggis-flavoured condoms. Right, guys, back me up on this. Who wants a blowjob with a condom on? Right? That's not working, right? That's the state of affairs. I'm using a Tesco bag and I return the favour. That's the way it's going. But even more so, what woman says, nah, I don't like the taste of punk, but the taste of awful and oatmeal and it smells like cotton. This'll do nicely. Whiskey flavour condoms. How fucking desperate for a blowjob do you have to be that the only person who's going to suck your cock is an alcoholic? Do you know what I'm saying? What's next, methadone flavoured condoms? I don't know. You know what it says on the side of these whiskey flavoured condom packets? Do not use if driving. Not joking. Why? I want to see that insurance claim form. I did not see the oncoming articulated lorry due to the large cock waving in front of me. Just bizarre. Anyway, you guys up for more comedy?
Yeah!
Excellent. We've got a wee sketch for you now called Piss Pooter. I've been Kieran McAllister. Thank you very much. Take care. Good night.
Yeah!
I need a piss, I need a piss, I need a piss. Oh shit, man, fuck, a queue. Mental queue for the toilet, that's God's punishment for women. Come on, hurry up, or it's going to be like singing in the rain in here. Good, that guy's going. I can get in, squeeze past him, get the fly undone, get the wee man out. Fuck, now I can't go. I was about to have a seizure a minute ago and now I can't go. My barely functioning cock is stage fright, I don't believe it. Shit, I can't piss next to somebody else. Come on, come on, pee, you motherfucker, pee. This guy's going to think I'm just in here to hold my cock. He's going to think I'm gay. He's going to think I'm in here to look at his cock. Don't look at his cock. Do not fucking look at his cock. Do not even go. I'm going to have to look at his cock. I can't believe it. I'm actually going to look at his cock. That's a cock. That's a fucking cock. He's in an operation or something because there's no way that's natural. He's been pissing for ages. What is he, a fucking racehorse? I've got penis envy and I've got a fucking penis. I still haven't squeezed out a drop. Stop thinking about his cock. Stop thinking about his... Oh, don't you do that. Don't you fucking dare do that. This is no fucking time to get a boner. You so much as twitch and I swear to God I'll cut you off. Think of something, think of something. Jackie Stallone, Richard Whiteley shagging Jackie Stallone tied Richard Whiteley with a strap on. Richard Whiteley, Countdown Conundrums, Carol Borderman. No, not Carol Borderman, not Carol Borderman. Carol Smiley, no big mouth, wanna come in it. Someone else, that guy in the front row, that guy in the front row. Yes, that's it, down boy, down boy. Now come on, just piss and concentrate. Concentrate on pissing. Squeeze and concentrate. Squeeze. Squeeze. I don't want a fucking fart, I need a piss! Okay, it's been a false alarm. I'm just going to have to pack up and go. I'm just going to have to put the wee casually out of here. Here I go, walking casually away.
Anybody here ever drunk a shitload of Buckfast and beat the shit out of somebody?
Yay!
Excellent. This song, next song is for you. It's a video clip got asked by a guy on the radio to write this tune. Did it in a studio, recorded it. Mates of mine, Mark Taylor, a whole bunch of comics helped us make this clip. Please enjoy. This is Buckfast.
You looking at? I'm a pure white bam if you know what I mean. Who the fuck are you looking at? Been touched by God, this tonic wine. Who the fuck are you looking at? It'll turn you into Satan if you drink it all the time. Who the fuck are you looking at? Pure net champagne going to my brain. We live in cold bridges, nothing in the fridge. Track man's a wife looking for a fight. You're like that, I'm like that. Who the fuck are you looking at? Buckfast.
Hey, go help, I'm the Australian. I am the annoying Australian that Kier told you so much about. Yep, nice to see you. Good to be here. You will find a lot of these jokes are around about 9 hours ahead of you. Excellent. Now, the last couple of months have been really wicked. We've got a new Pope. I'm very excited about that. Mainly because when one of my friends comes around and says, do you want to go down to the pub for a couple of pints? I can always go, is the Pope a Nazi? 9 hours ahead of you. Oh, yeah. Now, the other thing, I've got, I'm doing a bit of straw poll at the moment. Father's Day a couple of months ago. Everyone enjoy Father's Day? It's not that big these days, is it really? I mean, divorce rates, a lot of, you know, sort of single dads around and all that sort of thing. I think we need to update it. Just call it non-custodial Father's Day. I think that'd go well with all those guys from Fathers for Justice, because they do get a rough time of it, don't they? And a little Jimmy would be like that. He'd come around and go, my dad, love you so much. Oh, you know, it's non-custodial Father's Day. I only get to see you once a year and I might put you a present. What do you think about that? And his dad's turned around and he's just going, oh, wow, oh, that's cracking, son. Oh, grand, brand new Spider-Man costume. Well, okay, now go home and tell your mum she's ruined my fucking life! Not too many non-custodial dads in tonight. They're all committing suicide. Oh. I've had a rough week myself, actually. My girlfriend dumped me recently. Oh, no, 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 save your pity. I used to hit her all the time. It's amazing how long they'll hang around. I must say, doing a travel with a stand-up though, and I went to Ireland, discovered something about the Irish that not many people know. They were actually the first pirates, right? It's not recorded in history books per se. I worked it out by listening to their traditional music. Have a listen to this song and see if I'm not right. I'll tell me tomorrow when I get home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. I pulled my hair and stole my comb, that's alright when I get home. Arr! That's pirate music, isn't it? I won't bring you to being pirates. What would happen if Seamus go around to Patrick's house and go, Patrick, why don't we go out this afternoon and do a bit of the pirating? Patrick would be like, that'd be grand. Before we go, we should have a couple of wee whiskies. All hours later, they'd be sitting around and saying, all right, take those, pretty good, Patrick. I don't think we should go pirating tomorrow. But I'm in no condition to be driving a fucking boat. That's the way it works. It's good to be here. All this month we've been performing in this cave. When we first got here, they said it was haunted. You know, it's going to be haunted down here. It might be some ghosts. Ooh, ghosts. Ghost. Haven't met one ghost, but I ran into Osama bin Laden this afternoon. He's doing a show in Baby Belly 3. Weird man, George Bush can't find him, but he's walking around with all these flies with his face on it at 3:45 in the afternoon. Fuck, oh, you're not trying enough, are you, stupid cunt? Excellent. Guys, I do a bit of travel, as I say, and I went to Germany recently. Very good, good country, Germany, eh? When I was there, I went to the Dachau concentration camp. Gotta admit, it was a bit depressing, but I thought to myself, come on, you're in Germany, look on the bright side of this modern, efficient, and punctual public transport system. German people, when they're in Aitchison, walk around like this. Yeah, they're excited because they're gonna get up on the train, get there on time. We got back to the UK, everyone's standing around platforms doing this. You know why? Because you listen to announcements and they're just like this, you know, next train that's coming will be 10 minutes late. Train after that will be 10 minutes late. Train after that will be 10 minutes late. Train I first mentioned is now 20 minutes late. Not possibly coming. And I started thinking to myself, I reckon a lot of the Polish and the homosexuals and the Jews would have preferred the British ran the Holocaust. 8:15 to Auschwitz is 10 minutes late. 8:15 to Auschwitz has been cancelled. We apologise for the inconvenience. Always good to come back to Scotland after being travelling, eh? The land of deep fried everything. Through into Edinburgh Airport, they were like that. Deep fry your luggage for you! I'm reliably told that Scottish businessmen get up in the morning, right? And they say to their wives, have you ironed my shirts for me? Because they're a bit sexist, right? And they're like, have you ironed my shirts for me? And she'll just turn around and say, nah, I've deep fried it for you! That way you can sit on the train and pick butter off it and eat it for breakfast! Ah, oh, I'm a fucking pirate! Hey, now, anybody here been to, have you been over to Holland, been to Amsterdam? We go there for the windmills, don't we? Woo! Excellent. Now, when I travelled into Holland, I actually came in on the train from Germany, was running on time, right? Dropping in, looking out the window, like majestic mountains, we're still in Germany, majestic mountains, cross the border into Holland. How fucking flat is that country? It's ridiculous, man. I know they smoke a lot of pot over there now, but I reckon their explorers must have been a bit stoned, you know, just getting up for work all those hundreds of years ago, going, Oh yeah, gotta go to work today, not particularly up for it anyway, but here we go. Exploring over here, exploring over here, exploring over here. Oh, fucking mountain, oh fuck, can't put the border. Exploring over here, exploring over here, exploring. Oh, another mountain, I didn't bring my right shoes, fucking border. Yeah, wicked country, man, nice and flat. Fucking ride my bike around here. Yeah, better get a flag though. Hey, the French flag looks good. My work is done. And that's my work done for this whole festival. Thank you very much, Kieran.
The producers of Scotland 4, Australia 1 have bowed to considerable public pressure and placed a hidden camera backstage. This means we can now see what really goes on behind the scenes.
Oh no! Oh man. Hey Pete, come and check this out. This sound engineer's gone and topped himself as well. Oh, and he's ripped the toaster. Oh man, that was a cracking toaster.
Not that toaster. Oh, I still love that toaster. I wonder what he's going to say about that, man. Anyway, this fucking body, what are we going to do about that? I better go and get the black bags and the shovel, eh? Do you know where you left them last time?
I think they're in the van. Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, hey man, you're due on stage right now. Yeah. Come on, I'll go out there. Yeah, do a good show, right?
Scotland 4, Australia 1. It's not just about entertainment, it's about personal growth.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Mr. Pirie, Aitchison!
I'm going to video it for my mum. Okay, so I'll just shout some stuff out and you just kick it back to me. It's really simple, okay? Let's try this. Hey, Pirie!
Hey, Pirie!
You're so...
You're so...
Goddamn sexy! That's so kind of you. We'll try another one. Hey, Pirie!
Hey, Pirie!
Can we...
Can we...
have your babies? Old enough to be my baby. Popped up there a little bit. Right, just the one more. Hey, Pirie!
Hey, Pirie!
We can't believe...
We can't believe...
we're shouting this...
We're shouting this...
Mind you...
Mind you...
he's quite cute! Thank you very much. And looks a bit... like Andre Agassi! My mum will love that. So anyway, I was reading the newspapers today. Apparently in Edinburgh, the number of people injecting heroin has doubled in the last year. Yeah. In the same paper, Edinburgh City Council appear to have chosen as the new emblem for the city a puppy indigenous to Asia. Yeah, so hands up, who is actually here from Edinburgh tonight? People go, just one guy at the back. Now, I don't want you to take this personally, sir, but I live in Glasgow, and everybody from Glasgow just hates everybody in Edinburgh. You're just cheering hatred yourselves. You come from Glasgow. All right, okay, shut up then. Okay, right. So I was thinking, it's a bit daft. Why is it that everybody from Glasgow would hate everybody in Edinburgh? Why is it?
Yes.
Because you're English. Anyway, it is a bit daft, really. It's just a bit inner-city rivalry between the two biggest cities in Scotland. But I was in a bookshop the other day, and I picked out this guide to Great Britain, and I read the Glasgow and Edinburgh entries from that guide, and they went some considerable way, I feel, to explaining exactly why everybody from Glasgow would hate everybody in Edinburgh. So I've copied them out, and I'll just quickly read them to you now. So this was from Rick Steves' Great Britain, 2005. Some of you may have a copy. Edinburgh, the colourful city of Robert Louis Stevenson, is Scotland's showpiece and one of Europe's most entertaining cities. It's monumental, historical, fun, and well organised.
Glasgow. is one of the region's major transportation hubs. It has a bus station and two train stations. A 7-minute walk apart. It's quite accurate, really. For transport information, call 0144. That's exactly why everybody from Glasgow would hate everybody in Edinburgh. But yeah, I was really looking forward to coming here tonight though, because have you seen the little gypsies caravan halfway up the Royal Mile? You seen that? The little green and yellow one? Well, I went in there today and had my fortune told, and she said to me, Peter, when you come out in Edinburgh tonight, you're going to meet the woman of your dreams. And she'll just have a quick spin in the audience, and there she is there. What is your name, madam? Sonia. Sonia. Oh, I've got the video. Sonia, you have got no idea how much fun you're going to be having. Five minutes before I wake up tomorrow morning. It's going to be great. Now, I'm kind of doing a little bit of an experiment here in alternative chat-up lines. So, Sonia, what I'm really looking for you, could you give me some feedback on how I was doing there, chat-up line-wise? Give me some feedback. How was I doing? Yeah, I'm a stealth chat-up. your pants are half off and you didn't even know it. Just, yeah, was that the feedback? Give me some sort of something numerical or anything, comment. Some feedback on how my chat-up line was going there. Tonight. No? Before I was rudely interrupted there, is it true that you said, that was not bad, I suppose? Which is unfortunate because I've not actually written any material for a positive response. So I'll just have to go now. But, I know, but that's pretty much my time up, folks. I'm not writing any material. And, but before I go, I've got a couple of tips for the gentlemen in the room about things you should never ever say to your girlfriend. First of all, never ever say to your girlfriend, I am going to make love to you all night long. Turns out in Scotland, verbal contracts legally binding. And secondly, immediately after your orgasm, guys, don't shout, you've just been flanged by the phantom flan flail! Because they don't like that. Anyway, my name's Pirie, Aitchison, hope you have a great evening. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, in a change to the normal lineup of the evening, Kieran has asked us if he can sing you all a song. Now, as you heard earlier, Kieran has recently split up with his girlfriend, and the sadness that he feels as a result of this breakup has inspired him to write what I can only describe as probably one of the most beautiful ballads. Beautiful ballads that I have ever heard in my life.
Do you fucking get on with it?
I'm enjoying myself here. I think I'll stay on a bit longer.
Fucking encourage him.
Actually, that reminds me of a conversation I had with your mum last night. Is there a clinic for that? I don't know. No, it's all over for me. Right, so I'm off to cry. Andy, could you please welcome to the stage Kieran with his beautiful song.
Thanks for letting me do this. Who are desperate, so insecure that they can't stand alone on their feet. Love is what fuckwits confuse with romance, which only exists so a man can remove a girl's pants. And if I ever find myself falling again, I swear I'll remember the way that you fucked me right up. Love is the kind. What losers give freely to pricks who cheat on them, beat them, and generally treat them like shit. Love is for wankers who think they're unique and believe that their search for a soulmate will make them complete. If I ever find myself falling again, I swear I'll remember the way that you fucked me right up. And love is for cunts. Break it down. Jesus loved us all, so he died on the cross. Like a priest loves the child who he taught to suck hard on his cock. You'll know what I if you sing in this song, cause you're bitter and twisted and broken by love that went wrong. And if you ever find yourself falling again, remember the way that you felt when they said you were done. And the love is for cunts.
I started out many years ago in Mexico. That's where I sort of came up with my big thing on stupid, you know, and I'm starting to get a little bit sick of that. It sort of followed me around like some sort of a mouse with some cheese. I thought stupid all the movies, stupid all the books, stupid all the albums, stupid all, stupid all, stupid all. And I guess more to me than just sort of saying, hey, you are stupid, you know. It's not just the British tourists that are stupid, you know, sometimes terrorists are stupid, you know. Oh, I believe in something, I would have better be a better place, now I'm going to blow myself up, stupid, oh! I'm going to be playing Che Guevara. He's like a socialist revolutionary. His general message was, is there was a poor person there, and he would go to a rich person and say, rich people, give me the money! You know, and that was pretty much his message. He studied the writings of a guy called Karl Marx, of course, who is part of Marx Brothers. And what, he didn't do the poking out of the eyes and touching the nose and that sort of thing. He was in the back. He used to write a lot. He wrote a lot of books. I think one of the guys I really admire as an actor is Tom Cruise. He gets right into the character, you know. I like to get into... I like to get into Katie Holmes. When he was in the movie Born on the 4th of July, he did a time machine and he traveled back in time to the Vietnam War so he could learn what it was like to be a fighter pilot in the Vietnam War.
Tom Cruise traveled back in time to Vietnam to study for that role.
Yeah, because he was a fighter pilot.
Yeah, I remember the film, but you're saying he traveled back in time.
Yeah, he did. I think I would start by getting a, you know, you get them pigeons and when they walk, their heads move like that. I would get a pigeon to play a trumpet. It will try to lie on its back and hold the trumpet with its feet, and it doesn't work. So you have to have a special stand for that. So it's a bit of a lifelong dream of mine. I think it would make the world a better place.
Meanwhile, backstage at Scotland 4, Australia 1.
Hey, man.
Oh, no, Zan. Another sound engineer.
Aye.
Did you write the toaster? Man, that was my favourite toaster.
It was a good one, yeah.
This is unbelievable. He knows how I feel about toast, man. I brought a new jar of jam in from home. Just get rid of him, man. Get a new toaster in here.
Listen, guys, how are we going to get rid of this body? I mean, with all these people out there, they're going to notice something.
You know, they're watching a show, okay? Just confidence walking past. Just get rid of him, get a new toaster.
He's probably right, man. I'm going to go out and do a song. Paul can pull some faces. I mean, they'll be watching us, dude. Like, I don't think they'll notice a thing. Well, if you think it'll work out, you know, we'll give it a go.
And I can go to Dixon's on the way back.
Ah.
Oh, yeah, we can get one of them toasters, you know, auto reheat and defrost, you know, a nice chrome finish.
Excellent, yeah. Hey, let's get a four slicer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Four slicer.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the stage, Mr. Austin Lowe.
How are we, folks?
Good.
Yes, if you've not seen me before, yeah, I'm Austin, not Shaggy from Scooby-Doo. I get it all the time. It's just because he's my dad. No, he's actually my dad. Mom used to like drop a whole bunch of acid in the 80s, yeah, and the whole cartoon kind of became so real to her. She ended up shagging Shaggy in the back of the mystery machine, and I'm the result. Zoinks! yes, but it's great to be here. I know that this venue isn't the most comfortable with no backs in the seats, so because I'm such a nice guy, see if you stand up for one sec. It's not a trick or anything. And you give yourself a nice little stretch out. I know what it's like to sit on bench for ages. I used to play football at school. And then, rather than being nice, I'll give you a joke to take home with you, right? What's got four legs and stronger than Superman? Christopher Reeve's horse. Before we came down here to do the festival, we're up tuning in the Highlands, right? We were in Inverness, and I saw the best bit of graffiti in this toilet in Inverness, right? It said, I shagged your ma, then underneath it said, Dad, you're drunk, will you go home? when we go travel a lot and we eat at Little Chef. Has anyone ever been a Little Chef?
Yeah.
Yeah, fucking crap and disappointing, isn't it? When the chef was like 6'7". The 24th show, that's not got a laugh at. Keep it in there. But what else in the world am I talking about now? Oh, yeah, has anyone seen the film Super Size Me?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's crap as well, isn't it? Actually, those of you who haven't, this guy Morgan Spurlock, what he does for an hour and a half is eat McDonald's, like he's eating over the course of that whole month, and that's an experiment, right? And amazingly at the end he becomes a fan. The fuck do you think happens when you eat McDonald's every day? I mean, the fucking bar will not speed dating. It's just typical Americans, isn't it? Like, gee, you eat McDonald's, you get fat. Who the fuck that, man? What the fuck do we know? We wanted the Terminator in our fucking government, man. Fucking Bush. Let's go to SeaWorld. But I mean, it's just like, did he think he was going to like turn into Ronald McDonald? You know, it's like, and God was going to come down and go, congratulations, Morgan, you've made the right choice. Now follow me through the golden arches. It's brilliant. And keep a lookout for my movie, right? It's coming out. It's called Grande Latte. And what I do in that is I drink nothing but Starbucks for a whole month. And at the end of it, I become a pretentious wank. And as well, like, TV's really fucked up, don't you think? Disgust. Andrex. These Andrex toilet paper adverts, right? What the fuck has a puppy got to do with wiping your ass? What? How much coke do they take? So I just went, Mr. Andrex, I've got it! I did the beer idea, the sex, puppy! And it's like, you know what, Jenkins? You're fucking right, man. Puppies are so cute. People will love to wipe their ass with puppies. What do you want to say? For this honest, you know, that goes, last night Dave had 10 tequilas, 12 beers, and a chicken kebab. The next day he uses G-Rex Ultra Tough. No, he doesn't. does not. He uses Andrex all the time. Yes. Seamless. They didn't notice that. Is that even fucking? as well, before I get the first, it's one of my best friend's birthday, right? Is anyone here into anal sex? No, the guy's behind you all with their hands up, don't be shy. You say that just drives a mentor over the prison gigs, would you? Oh, he's like really into it, and I got this DVD called The Brown Canal, right? Sounded right up his alley. But yeah, he's really into it. Here's a fascinating fact for you, right? Apparently, the further you get through the process, you know, sex, right, the looser the asshole of the person actually becomes. So what you have to do right before your orgasm, guys, is like punch the guy or girl on the side. I'm not prejudiced. And everything like tightens up, and you have a really great orgasm. And that's where that world famous expression donkey punch comes from. Every day's a school day, folks. There you go. But I'm actually fucked up on that Brown Canal DVD. It actually was a documentary about the Clyde in Glasgow. But just before I go, I'm going to tell you about the best present I ever got was a trial membership to the gym. How much fun is that place, man? Whoa, you run, you don't fucking get anywhere. Lift it up and down, lift it up and down. What's the point? Morning as fuck! Just a bit excited since last night. But yeah, when you go get changed, that's the worst bit, right? It's the same at school, right? Guys go get changed and have a big fuck off empty no man's land of space to get changed in. And all the girls, you've only got that little private cubicle. How is that fair? You can't have a small fanny. Thank you very much. That's my last 5 minutes of Scotland for Australia 1. Yes! Thank you, guys!
Good. Oh, it's good to be. Well, the boys have been banging on about Michael Jackson quite a lot tonight, and you know, I just think guilty or innocent. Come on, Michael Jackson is a musical fucking genius, man. Seriously, and I reckon if he wants to fuck kids, we should just let him. Obviously, a few of them are going, "Whoa, that's a bit wrong." but no, look at it this way: we've been letting Catholic priests get away with that shit for hundreds of years, man. And I've never met a priest who can do the moonwalk. You certainly can't write a funky little bass line like this. I got some problems, it's plain to see when you look at me. My daddy beat me when I was 3 and danced out of step. I want to look like Johnny Depp. My best friend was a chimpanzee and he looked like me after I had all the surgery, and I am the one with my kid 30 feet from the ground. Janet always told me to get a better nose, but now I think she looks more like me. Yeah, she's singing songs with Justin. I guess the world is free, but it really freaks me out when she gets out her tits on TV. Michael Jackson is a bit of a worry. He hangs with kids and they're clever and they understand. Don't care if they tell on his head. Built a world where I could be me. I thought I'd free. I wrap my head sitting in a tree. In a sweat, and looking around. Take my strong advice. It's worse when you get caught out of class. People always tell me, be careful who you touch. You might want to ask for a form of ID. Yeah! Once I wrote a love song about a rat called Ben. When he came into the room, I thought he wanted cheese. Yeah! Michael Jackson is a bit of a worry. He sings like a girl and he acts like a bit of a wuss. But he's sane when compared with George Bush.
I know it's the metro, but what the hell? I mean, how many papers did you put this on?
I'm
know, 50, 60.
50, 60 people are going to see this?
50, 60,000, yeah.
You dick, I'm going to be a laughing stock.
But that's a good thing, Austin, you're a comedian.
You're going to regret this, Kier. Mark my words, you're going to ruin this day.
Hi, Grandma. It's Kier. Happy birthday. I brought you some milk. I know you like your milk. I just put it down there for you. Okay? I really miss you.
Kier! This is Grandma!
Grandma, is it really you?
Of course it is! Who were you expecting, Elvis?
I've got so many questions, Gran. I mean, how come... What's heaven like?
It's warm. But I come bearing a message.
A message?
Yes. You must follow a holy path.
Uh-huh.
Become a priest and help unfortunate people in Iraq.
In Iraq? But, Gran, I already have a job.
You must do it for Grandma. Become a priest. Move to Iraq!
I made you think you're grand, taught you from the dead. Now you're gonna be a priest and go to Iraq.
Yes, fly to myself, no work here, he's in Iraq. That won't do.
Australia 1. Debt never tasted so good.
Stage, Paul Pirie!
Hi there, I'm originally and I'm from Dundee, born and bred. Fuck, am I on dad? But yes, I live with my gran in Dundee. I like to call her my 82-year-old flatmate. And fantastic blowjobs which takes her teeth out though. I'm only kidding. Fucking hell, guys. She's shit, not very good. Does this weird thing though, my gran, right? She walks about going like that. I'm like, gran, where the fuck do you get a microphone from? You know what I mean? It's strange. But she does this weird thing as well, right? She sits on the phone. Well, doesn't sit on the phone. She sits with her legs wide open when she's on the phone with a skirt on, right? And you kind of go like that. Gran, oh fuck, I've just looked at you funny. Oh, but you can't help but want to look again. It's that horror movie moment in your life, you know, when you do that kind of, no, I really don't want to look, no, and then you kind of follow that blue vein right to the grey mound of hairiness, and then all this about, I'm only kidding. No, I'm only kidding. Obviously not, I sprinkled bits of chocolate. Buy your pubes off. I'm only kidding. I'm getting a nephew to do it. No, I'm only kidding, he's dead. Good in bed. No, but when it wore, do you remember that advert? We did this advert in Britain, right, about joining the army about 2 years ago, right? And there's a guy whose legs have been blown off, right? He's in a stretcher, right? He's going, like that, right? And it comes up, join the army. Join the army. Join the army. Right, and they get to the edge of this cliff, right? And the bridge is down, it's broken. And it's a 1,000-foot drop, and it comes up in this advert, right? What are you thinking? I'm thinking, thank fuck I'm not in the army. Because it's not guns that kill people, it's Americans that kill people. Any Americans in? You have to have a gun, you don't make the noise. You know what I mean? How come the Americans were killed in friendly fire? Because they've no friends. Suicide bombers, what makes them tick? If you notice when fat people go to McDonald's, right, they always order loads of food, don't they? They always go, hi, they have loads of hamburgers, please, loads of French fries, Diet Coke, some ironic reason, right? And their food takes a bit longer for it to come, because they've ordered loads of food, doesn't it? And the guy and the girl delivering the food always goes like that, there's your meal, sorry about your weight. When fat gay people walk in a pub, homophobics always go like that. There's a gay boy, quickly lads, backs against the wall. does not stop blowjobs. But yes, yeah, I sign on at the moment as well, but my careers officer at school said to me once, she goes, Paul, what are you going to do when you leave school? I said, I'm going to go home, have my dinner and watch Neighbours. Well, they got me this job in the camp house, right, which is a kind of shithole in Dundee, right, basically you wipe your feet on the way out, right, and what they do, right, is you have to deliver food. Right, there's a skill to this, because you notice when people always go out to you, there's your meal, okay, enjoy your meal, and watch the plates are hot, okay, enjoy your meal. Me, first day working there, like this. Ah! Enjoy your fucking meal! Ah! Do you know what I mean? And they went, Paul, can you work behind the bar, please? So I'm working behind the bar, right, and you get a bit bored, you get a bit curious, right, and I look, and there's a lost property box, and I open it, right, and there's just loads of walking sticks. How the fuck can you forget a walking stick? Do you know what I mean? Can you imagine halfway up the road like that? I'm sure I've forgotten something. I was in the camp house about 5 minutes ago, man. It's just stupid as fuck, isn't it? But never ever have an argument with somebody in a swimming pool. Because when you go in the huff, you look stupid as fuck. Do you know what I mean? You do that kind of, fuck you then, I've had enough of you. I've just had you up to here, okay? So get lost. Goodbye. Never ever give a dwarf a yo-yo. Pointless. No. Do you know what I won't play at my funeral? Tennis. Or cricket, whoever wins gets the ashes. So remember that famous R.E.M. song that they sung about when you had sex with the Undertaker? That's me and the coroner. But yes, has anybody seen the film American Werewolf in London? Yeah. Have you seen the singer Lionel Richie? Yeah. Well, we were a bit stoked. No, we weren't. No, somebody was throwing bricks at us. No, we were watching the DVD, right? Do you not think mid change, he looks like Lionel Richie? Do you not? He does that kind of. Hello. we celebrate Easter. Easter's that famous time when Jesus pushed that rock over and it broke and loads of Smarties fell out. And there's a wee bunny in the background like that. Twice. That was the second coming. It's true. No. But yes, this is how sad I am, actually, okay? I sit on my own, on the phone. I can't pool. Sit on my phone, on my own, but like that. No, you replace the handset and try again. Do you ever phone the drink helpline and go, hello, hi, I've got a bottle of wine here, but I don't have a bottle opener? Or the drug helpline, hello, I'm not from Edinburgh, we're at school. Okay, I'm going to show you a magic trick before I go. Everybody see this? Oh, something about a guy in specs. He can't see, that's what it is. Is it this side now? I've been popping it, guys. Have a fantastic evening.
Now 3 years, 2 years, 10 months professionally. Obviously, some people say not very long, Lenny. I go, well, obviously, I'm quite talented. I've just risen faster than anyone else out there. Risen like a steam train. Yes, I did my first gigs down in London, but not a great place, London, no. Well, London doesn't like to laugh very much. To be honest, the venues they have are too small, the chairs aren't that comfy, and the microphones, well, they're not the right colour.
Do you have problems being understood when you're in London?
Well, no, because as a performer, I'm a master of all accents.
So give us an example of your London accent.
Oh, my London, no problem. All white, gov. Spain, Italy, France, America, all the places in Europe.
And do you do, like, say, a French accent or something?
Oh, yes, that's one of my favourites, yeah.
Can you, how does that go?
Oh, no, buongiorno.
Isn't that more Italian?
No, it's French.
The name of your first show,
yes.
What was that again?
Lenny Mango, not Orange, yeah. Well, apparently the Orange Order didn't think that was very funny. Obviously, it was a fruit-related joke, just taken somewhat out of context, but I had no idea the extent of the Orange Order's kind of
organisation.
But you've lived in Scotland most of your life.
Yes, but no one had told me. I honestly don't fit in with the norm. I'm what you call a seasonal topical comedian. Well, basically, seasonal is when you do jokes relating to a time. Christmas, you would do jokes in December, obviously. April Fools on the 1st of April, but I like to do that in May. Keep them on their toes. Like Camilla, Charles, Michael Jackson, all very topical. You know, some things, you know, like September 11th was topical. Just before this, September 11th of 2001. But I'm hoping very soon that that's going to become seasonal. You need to be in the industry the whole time. I think Michael Jackson would agree with me on that. What people need to realise, you know, is that you've always got to work within your field. This will make you better. Because people look at Billy Connolly, you know, and they go, oh, he's fantastic, very naturally funny. And I go, but he was a welder. He's actually, by the way, French.
So what did you do before you got on stage doing stand-up?
Well, I was always performing and working with people who had an audience.
What, doing what in particular?
Basically, it was handing out flyers dressed as a pineapple. Basically, I got this big project, big broadcast, can't tell you which channel, cannot tell you the channel. And basically, what they've done is they've given me this, like, you think this is a phone, it looks just like a phone. You know, it's got buttons like a, rings like a phone. It is a phone. But what it has on it is a camera. I can go backstage and I can sit quite inconspicuous and film.
And you've got a camera in your phone?
Yes.
Because there's cameras in most phones.
No, this is a special camera. Well, my advice to everybody is to follow your dreams unless it's just clear that you're not talented enough to reach them.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lenny Mango, please! Okay, now I'm single now. I've got a wee song about it, actually, and I can tell you that Natalie Umbrulli has heard this, and she thought it was brilliant. And so if you don't like it, that means you don't share the same opinion as a washed-up Australian songstress. I'm having no luck with the chicks. I buy them drinks, I chat them up, they all give me the flick. When I want to touch their tits. So I guess I'll have to find a whore. Who I can pay to get me laid, for I may never score. But I'm just too fucking poor. It's no use, I have no luck. Why can't I get just one fuck? What's going on? I think I'll watch some porn. I've worn out the tape. Calluses I feel. Cold and I'm ashamed, lying naked on the floor. Right from me mates, I love that European. It's not from the States, I can't understand the Danish porn. It is 8:30, and I am watching porn. But now I live with my own wife. She yells at me and always screams, you've got no fucking life. She caught me on the net last night. We're breaking up, the sex is gone. She's getting phone calls from Shane Warne. What's going on? I think I watched some porn. I collected lots of tapes since I was 13. But they're old and out of date. They're VHS, not DVD. Stolen from me mates. Still love that European. It's not from the States. I can't understand the German porn. Divorce is on the way, but I am watching porn. Porn.
applause for our techie tonight, Rowan, and also Sandy. They've worked tirelessly. We wouldn't have this show with the guys for the back. Please, big round of applause, Sandy and Rowan. Okay, now we also need to mention our sponsors, Cameron Presentations, who supplied us with the video projector. They went above and beyond the call of duty to help us out, lots of technical advice, and saved us a couple of times. So they were great. If you need anything in that sort of area, audio, visual stuff, please grab the number off the card, give them a call. That's the last time that I have to say that. And we're going to wrap up this last show, Scotland for Australia 1, with, you heard the Buckfast song before, but it's so much more fun live. And if you like, feel free to sing along. The words go like this. Who the fuck are you looking at? It's not that difficult. Okay, let's rip into it! I've been drinking bunnies since I was 13. Who the fuck are you looking at? I'm a pure white man, if you know what I mean. Who the fuck are you looking at? Been touched by God, this tonic wine. Who the fuck are you looking at? It'll turn you into Satan if you drink it all the time. Who the fuck are you looking at? Doing that champagne, going to my brain. We're living cold fridge, there's nothing in the fridge. Track pants are white, looking for a fight. You're like that, I'm like that. Who the fuck are you looking at? Sing it! Fuck bass! Who the fuck are you looking at? Sing! Fuck bass! Who the fuck are you looking at? Drink, buck fast. Who the fuck are you looking at? Drink, buck fast. Who the fuck are you looking at?